CQDX, CQDX, CQDX. This is Havana calling. CQDX, CQDX, CQDX. This is Radio Havana calling. Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communication.
Hi, mis amigos radio aficionados all around the world that are now listening to this, the middle of the week edition of your favorite radio hobby program. This is the DXers Unlimited coming to you from Radio Havana Cuba, the Shortwave. The URL is www.radioxc.cu, and it provides streaming audio of our programs in different languages at the proper bitrate for easy listening on the web. Arnaldo, Anicoro, Radio Amateur Show 2KK, and here's item one of today's show. Sad to say, we must patiently wait. The worst summer high frequency DX season in history for propagation conditions to take us to the better. Wait and see. The better conditions will hopefully start by mid-September of this year. The expected propagation enhancement is related to a very well-known characteristic of the atmosphere during the equinoctial period. I'll explain this to you now. What is happening during the equinoctial period after local sunset is that the ionosphere is responding to the impact of solar ultraviolet radiation reaching it from the sun. So the number of free electrons per cubic centimeter actually increases. As the free electrons at the height of the S layer increase, the maximum usable frequency also increases, and that is exactly what happens. Let me tell you about examples of this typical phenomenon that happens 2 weeks before and 2 weeks to 3 weeks after the autumn equinox of our hemisphere and the spring equinox of the southern hemisphere and all the way around. Next. CO2JA Jose Amador, a well-known Cuban radio amateur and telecommunications engineering professor, told me about how he had worked many European and Middle East stations on the 20 meters band starting just after sunset and on to very late in the evening local time here in Havana during the 2015 season, that's 3 years ago. Following his advice, I'm planning now to operate with a well-output single side band transceiver monitoring the 20 and 17 local midnight, that is 0400 UTC, and sure enough, staying up late while running the very low power station. Yes, you must stay up late, and if you are an amateur radio operator that finds the 20 meter band with no signal, then do this, what I'm telling you. Start calling CQDX as soon as you are able to pick up the first 19 meter band international broadcast stations on your radio. You will soon find out that the ever-growing problem of lack of activity on the amateur bands was the cause of very few or no stations heard, and that your CQDX calls acted like a magic wand, and also the 30 meters band for DX. As a good friend of mine likes to say, he has been able to work some of the most challenging DX expeditions for a dead band. Apparently, totally unoccupied band that was actually wide open for long distance propagation right to the spot where the DX station was located. Now, item two. The Amateur Radio Academy tests take place in many of the Cuban provinces twice every year during the weekend, so that everyone can participate. Radio Amateurs here in Cuba provide much needed communication. For example, when rivers well above their flood stage levels cut land links with the respective provincial capitals, then communications via ham radio works at the best. Whenever a tropical cyclone or hurricane approaches, radio amateurs are on the emergency net with stations on the 2 meter band, while a lesser number go on the air using the 40 meter band during the daytime and 80 meter band at night for near vertical incident skyway propagation. During the month of May of this year, the annual meteor emergency group took place. The excellent coordination between the provincial radio club, the municipal base club, and the national and provincial civil defense command post makes excellent use of the available resources, both in manpower and equipment available. Amateur radio shows how it is capable of deploying stations at even the most difficult to reach locations, and once there, the ability to using the locally available resources. Of the middle of the week edition of the DXers Unlimited coming up. You're listening to the DXers Unlimited, and here is QSL on the air. It goes to Amigo Ramos, who reports regularly from Utah, USA, where he listens via shortwave on our 6165 kHz 49-meter band frequency, and also pick up our streaming audio from www.radiohc.cu. Randall comments in his email message the following that I now quote. He says, I think that with the addition of some of the newer digital modes like the FTA mode and others, the new world interest in amateur radio is definitely growing. I've had some discussions with a few other hams that have expressed to me that the art of CW, Morse code radio telegraphy, is also growing. There's still the magic of radio. Job in showing the general public how important and vital useful amateur radio is, then amigo Randall adds in his message, I do see a lot more interest now due to current press releases and other media coverage. And he also said in his letter, of course, I'm a job in promoting the hobby of amateur radio as well as the hobby of shortwave listening. In regards to what I'm seeing on radio, shortwave listening is on the right. But listeners are a little frustrated as the interest increases, but the number of stations going dark increases as well. This shows just how out of touch many station managers have been, and I think a lot of that is due to the lack of these stations interfacing with the listeners by not responding to letters or USL requests. Finally, I was very happy to read the last part of Ronald's email that I now quote. I was using a regularity receiver and a 60-foot random wire. I listened from 0200 to 0300 UTC on the 49-meter frequency, 6165 kHz, and the signal was a solid 5 simple. The depth of the audio was beautiful and better than many local FM stations. And I do thank a lot amigo Randall Tripp, and I tell him to keep to the DXers Unlimited. Amigos, our most important show item for here today. You have questions, and Arnie tries to answer them as soon as possible, directly to your email address, like this one. And then the USL, your section of DXers Unlimited, will be answering questions sent by listener Ernesto from London, Ontario, in Canada. Ernesto wants to know why his radio reception on the shortwave band becomes quite noisy when it is snowing. He also asks that depending on the type of disturbance to shortwave radio reception, what experts describe as precipitation static noise sounds differently, and I may add that it disappears as soon as it stops snowing. Here in the tropics where I live, the precipitation static noise happens when it is raining at a high bit rate. I understand that the snow-induced noise is much higher than the noise generated by a local heavy rainfall than the ones we have here in the tropics. During heavy rain, you will also notice an increase in atmospheric background noise too, and of course many static crashes from the thunderstorms. And now, amigos, as always, at the end of the show, when I am here in Havana, ready to copy, Arnie Coro's high frequency propagation update and forecast. The current propagation conditions, solar terrestrial indices for the 10th of July follow, solar flux near 73 units, and the estimated planetary K index, nice and low too. The estimated planetary K index at 0900 UTC on the 10th of July was just 2. No space weather storms were observed for the past 24 hours. No space weather storms are predicted for the next 24 hours. And please, amigos, do not forget to send me your comments about this program to info@inet.cu. Any questions you may want to ask, please do so. Feel free to do this. And also send your questions and your comments via airmail to Arnie Coro, Radio Havana Cuba, Havana Cuba, and via internet to the internet address info@inet.cu.
That's all for today. This is Arnie Coro, Radio 2KK, your host here at Radio Havana, DXers Unlimited, saying 73 and very good DX.
DXers Unlimited, heard every week here on Radio Havana Cuba. Actually, twice a week. We've got the weekend edition and now this midweek edition here on Radio Havana Cuba.